You're watching Proactive. I'm joined by Marshall Abbott, the CEO of Arrow Exploration. Marshall, very good to speak with you again.
Stephen, good to be talking to you again. Thank you.
You're welcome. So you've spud your first horizontal well on the Tapir block in Colombia, and it looks like a significant milestone for Arrow.
Yeah, this is a very exciting step for us. We have made this significant discovery about a year ago, and we've been doing the planning to drill horizontals to exploit this amazing reservoir ever since. So we've looked at reservoir simulation, the actual drilling of the horizontal well. We've brought in additional talent that in aggregate gives us about 400 horizontal wells of experience. So we're very confident that we can execute from an operational perspective. The reservoir has already defined itself with the five wells we've drilled into it, in addition to the 3D seismic over it, that we're going to be able to drill horizontal laterals 500 meters in length at the top of the reservoir. And this reservoir is a textbook case of how to exploit horizontally. So yeah, we're very excited. We put a lot of work into it. Now it's time to execute.
Marshall, explain why horizontal drilling will deliver this step change in production and be transformative for Arrow?
Very good question, Steve. So let's look at how we drilled this initially with vertical wells down to 9,500 feet. We've got anywhere from 60 to 70 to 90 feet of pay at each one of those wells. And so when you complete one of those wells, you're completing 15 feet. So you're exposing yourself to 15 feet of reservoir. When you're drilling a horizontal, you're exposing yourself to 550 meters of reservoir. And so you're pulling on the reservoir with a lot less effort. And that way you're not bringing in water prematurely. So horizontals will, in our modeling, produce approximately 2 million barrels of ultimate recovery each. So when we finish drilling the first horizontal, we're going to drill a vertical well, and that's going to be a water disposal well. And then the balance of this pad, we have five cellars on this pad, with three additional horizontals will be targeting the zone. And we probably have room for 10 horizontals in aggregate. So the first one's very important. We expect very aggressive rates. We're not going to pull on the well too hard. And just as an example, the vertical wells can flow very aggressively and you can cone water relatively quickly, but the horizontal wells will flow naturally and not bring in water as aggressively as the vertical wells do. Excuse me.
And Marshall, you're expecting production in June already?
Yeah, so we spud the well 2 or 3 days ago. We'll be at target depth in approximately 12 days. And then we will insert a slotted liner that along the length of the horizontal lateral will prevent any sand production from coming in, but will, of course, allow for oil to flow into it. And we expect production results in the first week of June. We're going to let the well increase production very slowly. And then we'll be talking about the results into the second week of June, likely.
You say in the announcement this is a milestone in your development plan for the Ubaqui Reservoir. So I presume more to follow after this one if it's successful.
Absolutely. And one of the keys, Stephen, as I mentioned, was being able to deal with the water production that comes with the oil. So we've got dedicated disposal wells to take care of the water production. The water is very fresh and it's easy to separate. And so we'll be producing clean oil once we treat it at surface. And when we do get it to surface, we take no transportation risk. We have a number of buyers lined up to take that crude. And we have about a $15 discount to Brent. So the netbacks at 12% royalty are very aggressive here. It's an excellent fiscal regime, especially for a reservoir like this.
Marshall, what other drilling do you have planned for 2024?
Very good question, Stephen. So we have an approved $45 million capital budget. We're not quite halfway into that. So we're going to drill the five wells at the Carrizales Norte pad. Then we're going to move just to the north to drill a very low risk exploration well called Bacchiano. And the Bacchiano morphology is very similar to what we encountered at Carrizales Norte. We have three-way closure up against a fault. And when you've got that in the Llanos Basin on the Tapir block, there's a 90% chance of success. So we're going to drill a suite of wells at Bacchiano, and then we're going to move to a very similar looking prospect on a different fault trend called the Capullo prospect. Again, very similar morphology. We've got three-way closure up against a fault. It's likely oil filled. Then we're going to move up to the Mataguafa prospect. Very similar morphology. Again, there are two wells that have recovered about 650,000 barrels drilled in the 1990s without 3D seismic. You need 3D to really make it happen. And then we'll come back and start drilling additional horizontals at the Carrizales Norte pad. So yeah, it's an exciting year for us.
Well, sounds like a busy year for you as well, Marshall. I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress. Thanks for speaking with us today.
Thanks for the opportunity, Stephen. We look forward to an exciting year.
Welcome. That's Marshall Abbott. He's the CEO of Arrow Exploration.